So, Mike, if you were a Lucha Libre, what would your name be?
The Spine Ripper.
Oh my god. Aggressive. Yeah. My wrestling name?
Yes. But I think that means fat.
Pretty sure that means the boss.
I think maybe fat. You're a fat boss.
Just call me fat?
Yes.
Congratulations, everybody. You've seen the first Brewtopia fight.
I'm sorry. Hello, I am Mike, this is Lou, and after a little hiatus from the studio, we are back. We are Brewtopia.
We have been doing a lot of events, so yes. It's weird they'll be staring at a camera again.
Yeah, we've been on the little Brewfest tour, the festival tour.
The Birkin Fest, we had Gary's Brewfest, we had...
The Delaware Beer Awards.
Delaware Beer Awards?
Yeah.
You went to Colorado.
I went to Colorado. Colorado, Rocky Mountain High. And stopped at the Post Brewery, which is in Lafayette, Colorado. They also have another brew pub in Boulder, Colorado. And we picked up some beers while we were out there.
He didn't invite me.
Didn't.
Mm-mm. I'm not mad.
There wasn't room in the car. It was crowded.
Not bad.
All right. So the two beers that we have are called Top Rope. It's a Mexican style lager, and Ol Zippy, which is an American ale. The reason why we stopped at this brewery was because he's semi-famous, especially in this area. Bryan Selders, who is the head brewer at Dogfish. You gotta keep pinching pennies, man. You gotta shop it around to pay as little as you can. You gotta keep pinching pennies, man. With no doubt, so you can pay the full amount. Took a little hiatus from Dogfish for a little while and went out to Colorado and started this brewery while he was out there, and actually got to tour the brew house while we were there. And the brew house is actually designed so that one man, him, could run the whole brew house and make a beer lineup of over 30 beers by himself. It was pretty impressive to see.
Smart man.
It was a fun time, got a little tour. They had some great food there. They're apparently known for their fried chicken. I had a chicken pot pie while I was there. It was pretty delicious.
So I was reading up on the post, and they said they try not to overwhelm your palate with all these flavors so you could enjoy your food.
So the beers, what we read was the beers have been designed to match well with the foods that they offer in their restaurant. So they're really almost foodies first, and then they designed the beers to match the food. So, Top Rope, again, is a Mexican-style lager. It's a 5% ABV, alcohol by volume. And I really find this can interesting. It's got a Lucha Libre on it. And obviously, Top Rope is a reference to wrestling. Yes, giving him the business off the Top Rope. The Top Rope business.
Is that what you call it? The Top Rope business?
I've just taglined it.
Hashtag Top Rope
business. Yes, we're going to trademark it. The entire label with the description of this beer is in Spanish, so...
Neither of us speak Spanish.
Un pequeño, but no es mucho español. It's meant to be kind of a crisp, refreshing beer. What do you think?
I like it. It definitely has that cold, crisp lager feel to it.
I was surprised when I tried it. It's very smooth.
It's light. It's very light.
Very crisp. I feel like if you weren't careful, you could probably drink a lot of these and not even realize it.
Right.
So, but I mean, it's a good beer. I liked it. What do you put it on the hop meter?
The hop meter? I'm pretty neutral about this beer. I'm gonna give it a middle of the road and put 5.
Okay.
It's a good light beer.
Right. I would probably say that it's a 6. I'm gonna give it a 6 in this case, because I think, it's a beer that you could probably, you know, if you're out cutting grass on a...
Oh, that's a great grass cutting beer.
That is a grass cutting beer. you're cutting grass on a Saturday, you're out riding the mower, you could probably cut 10 lawns.
So many lawns.
Just cutting away.
So many lawns.
All right, and Old Zippy.
Old Zippy.
The can here has a picture of a squirrel on it.
I really hope there's a squirrel that's always there and they called him Old Zippy.
Yeah, that would be cool.
That's, I don't even care. That's what's in my head now.
And it's inspired by the great Candales of North America and the Northeast.
Old
Zippy features a crisp malt flavor, snappy hops aroma, a hop zing. I would say that the Old Zippy is very similar, I think, to almost like a Yingling, but like a more toned down Yingling. Go ahead and try it, see what you think.
What is it, premium?
I don't know, but it's also 5% alcohol beer. And it's an A.
And also, I feel like there's a lot of similarities between these two beers. Again, not overwhelming to your palate.
So it's very smooth.
Yeah, very smooth. It definitely has like, again, a very like crisp, refreshing style to it. This is not the kind of beer that's gonna like sit heavy in your stomach.
Right.
Very light and casual. Lawn mowing approved.
Yeah, pretty good summer beers. And I would agree. It's very smooth. It's got a Christmas to it, a crispness to it.
Merry Christmas.
Yeah. And I guess just to share a little backstory even, like when we were in Colorado, right now on the East Coast, there's a bit of a fad to kind of add a lot of lactose and some fruit.
Some hazy IPA.
Yeah, the hazy IPA fad is on the East Coast right now. That was not the case in Colorado. In Colorado, everything was pretty much your pure old standard beers. Like the IPAs were very clean and clear and filtered and hoppy. Your ales and your lagers were very crisp and refreshing. So I mean, this the difference that we're tasting here, the smoothness, the
it's a cultural thing
could be the beer culture of Colorado.
Well, I know a lot of people in Colorado, they're like very like fit friendly, so maybe the lighter beers are that match that light fit atmosphere.
Correct.
Gotta keep pinching pennies, man. You gotta shop it around to pay as little as you can. You gotta keep pinching pennies, man, with no doubt, so you can pay the full amount when it counts.
Well, that's what we got for you.
Welcome back.
Hey! Just remember that if you're gonna binge on anything,
binge on Brewtopia.
Binge on Brewtopia. Yes.
We're dealing with frog issues.
We got a frog on the loose.
Technical difficulties.
Oh my god.
That's not funny!
Not at me.
That frog is so like, I'm sure there's
what do you mean?
Get me out of here.
Get it out, Kate. Stick your hand in that horn.
I wanna rock right now. I'm raw bass and I came to get down. I'm not internationally known, but I'm known to rock the microphone because I get stupid. I mean outrageous. Stay away from me if you're contagious, cause I'm a winner. No, not a loser. To be an MC is what I choose. Ladies love me, girls adore me. I mean, even the ones who never saw me, like the way that I rhyme at a show. The reason why, man, I don't know. So let's go, cause